Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another Android Studio tutorial. And today I will show you how to use WebView, which is actually going to convert your website or any HTML pages into an Android app. So let's go to the Android Studio. And we have a blank project with the name My Application. And all we have to do is just find the WebView inside this palette. And hopefully here is the WebView. You can also find it under the containers. And here it is. Just drag the WebView into the center. Okay, so here is the WebView, and all we have to do is simply give it an ID in order to declare the WebView into this main activity. So we have to give it an ID, and I just want to give it as WebView itself. Now let's move on to the main activity. We have nothing to do with the activity underscore main.xml. So let's move to the main activity, and you have to declare the WebView inside the onCreate method. So WebView, I'm giving the variable name as WebView itself, then equal to, then find view by ID, okay, then r.id.webview. And so you have seen that I have declared the WebView and many other IDs like WebView, then or the widget, then the variable name and equal to. And once that done, I actually done a inside the bracket, I have already given the widget or the layout or whatever else the name inside this bracket. So today in this case, I'm not going to give it as inside this bracket. Instead, I'm directly return the find view by ID after this equal to sign. So what I'm going to do today is that simply pressing two keys on the keyboard to actually write all other codes and cast it into that particular widget or layout file or whatever else. So actually what I'm going to do is that I'm going to press the left alt on my keyboard and keep pressing the left alt. I'm just going to press the enter at the center of this keyboard. So when I press the enter, you can see here is a pop-up which shows that cast to Android WebKit dot then WebView. So it is actually going to import this WebView into this inboard gallery. So what I'm going to do is simply press the enter, and you can see here it added inboard android.webkit.webview. So you can able to cast WebView and many other widgets and many other things directly by just pressing the alt enter, and you can cast it into this inboard. So what we are going to do next is that we have to give a URL or the file name to be opened inside this WebView. So I'm going to type the variable name of the WebView, and next I'm adding a dot, and now we have to type load URL, which is going to get the URL value or the file name or the file location where we kept the index file or the HTML file to be loaded inside the WebView. So what we have to do is in this case I'm going to give the WebView load URL as http then www.google.com. So what it actually do is that now the WebView will going to load the google.com inside this WebView file. So if you want to load a file in from the Android application itself, or if you want to load a HTML file inside this WebView, then you have to simply change the HTTP and blah 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 into file, then colon, then we have to add 3/, then Android assets slash, then inside the asset you have to give a HTML file name. In for example, I'm going to give it as index.html. So this is a basic example of when we are going to open the WebView using the index.html file that is kept inside this Android application. So in order to use this method, you have to learn something called using the Android assets, which I'm going to discuss in the next video. So for this example, I'm going to use the HTTP then google.com. You can give it as anything as you want. So once that is done, Now, when we are running the application on your live device, we can see that the WebView is going to open the google.com. But if you want to go with something more advanced in the WebView, like you like enabling the JavaScript in your WebView and able to load the websites that contain JavaScript and many other pop-ups, then you have to add a simple line that is webview.getSettings.setJavaScript enabled. Inside this, we have to declare a boolean value which is going to be true. Now the JavaScript is enabled, and if you want, we can also add one more line which enable the WebView to be loaded inside this application itself. So that is webview.setWebViewClean, then new WebView clean. So the reason why I added this line is that most of the people are complaining that the WebView is actually going to open in the default browser and it's not going to open in the newly created Android application. So for those people, then I highly recommend using this line, which is going to replace the default browser with the application itself. So we have completed all the lines. The final step is going to be inside the manifest folder. So in order to the WebView to get the internet, we have to give the permission for the application to use the internet. In the area that we are going to specify the permission is going to be the Android manifest, which is going to be under the app, and inside the manifest folder we have the Android manifest.xml. Let's open that, and under the package we have to declare permissions. So now what we have to do is simply add a less than symbol, now use permission, and we have to add internet, and finally we have to close the permission tag. Okay, so now we have everything that we required. Now let's move on to the Android device and check it out. So guys, we have the application in our live device, and as you can see now it's loading the google.com. So I hope you guys got the idea, and if you like this video, definitely give it a big thumbs up. And if you have any kind of doubts, you can comment below this video. And if you haven't subscribed, let's do it now. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in my next video.